Hey guys, not sure if anybody is out there this late at night. I've been trying to get this video out all day long and it just hasn't been divine timing until now. And I can now see why. Well, first of all, I'll start with what ignited this video. Oh, someone's here. Melody, Sheila. Hey guys, it's Ria and my son, Caleb. I keep saying I'm gonna bring him on. Hey, Rose, Sheila Rose. Thanks for joining us, guys. So I'm just gonna give a brief little thing before we begin. But this morning, after I dropped my son off at school, not this one, my 10-year-old, and that gives me, creates a space for a long time. And music always speaks to me. And so a Prince song came on, Let's Go Crazy. And I knew that I was supposed to share my interpretation or Prince's interpretation of the song to you guys today. But you know, sometimes when you first think of something, you're really excited and then the energy might die down. Well, I always get affirmation also to follow through on what I'm receiving. And so I was listening to two lives, one done by Zara today, and she mentioned crazy, something about being crazy in her card reading. And then Jason also mentioned about coming across as crazy. And I'm like, there's my sign. And so then I was looking at the lyrics of Let's Go Crazy by Prince. And just to give you another little thing, Prince appeared to me after death. I see stuff a lot. So I was fully awake and I have visions a lot. And so I was awake in my room and I look and there's Prince elevated in the corner of my room, like a miniature Prince. I knew it was Prince. He was wearing purple. And you know, it was the typical Prince, how he appeared to us in this life. So he made his connection with me then. And so that just reassured me even more when I was feeling that nudge, feeling the energy to be guided to do this. So I trusted it. And so Caleb, he was like resting all day and I didn't want to bug him. And then I'm like so excited, I'm shaking him. I'm going, Caleb, we need to do this interpretation with me. I says, it's Prince's song, Let's Go Crazy. And he goes, what did you say, Caleb? Oh, he said that he was just invited to Church of the Prince.
Prince of Peace.
Oh, Prince of Peace.
It was a Lutheran church, and it was just a weird coincidence that she...
No coincidences!
Yeah, you're right. I don't believe in coincidences. That's right. Thank you for checking me. So, yes.
So, anyways, that was my third affirmation of the day. The two crazies and then the prince. And just one other point I want to make is I didn't get to it until this late because I happened to just look on my Facebook real quick and look under notifications. And Christina Tibbetts wrote me this most amazing explanation to a post that I posted today, a bunch of hearts on my run, and what card reading kind of was for me. It's an art form, and she talked about how art to her is light, symbols, vibrations, and she explained it so beautifully. So if you get a chance, go to my post from today about card readings being an art form. She had a beautiful explanation, and she's like, I'm not good with words. I always felt stupid because words aren't adequate, and she's so right. Words aren't adequate to the music, or like light and vibration. It's a third language. It's a language that can't be spoken. It can only be felt, and you can only vibrate it out. It's only something that you can communicate, feel through your entire being. Your entire being feels the vibration, and she's so gifted, because to me, that just represents her never losing her connectedness and her connection, or shall I say awareness, to the multidimensionality aspects that she's connected with, and her connectedness to everything. She feels everything. And I totally resonated with everything she said because I feel it, but she made me, what it did is it gave me also affirmation why I interpret music and why I, you know, symbols speak to me. And when she said that she sees in symbols, spirit will speak to me in symbols. Like, I get messages at night And then I wake up and I'm totally awake and a symbol will appear before me. And it's not necessarily a geometric symbol, but I'll just give you a quick example. I was sleeping with my son Mythos, putting him to bed. And then one night I wake up and I'm always fully conscious and I see this pine cone going through his head. And I'm like, well, what the heck does that mean? Because I see stuff like that all the time. Everything stands for something. It's always symbolic. Well, my little guy was in need of case management. I was looking for some services like Special Olympics and stuff for him. And that pine cone came for me as a sign before I even found out about it. But I hooked him up to the Pine Tree Society. Pine Tree Society, hence the pine cone going through his, like, you know, going through his head. So it was to help him and to guide me. And when I came across the Pine Tree Society, it was affirmation. So I totally understand what you're saying, Christina, and totally resonate, because everything is symbolic. It's greater than words, like you said. There's only, our English language is so limited by words. So beautiful, beautiful explanation. And so get to the point here, why me and Caleb are here. I thought I was going to do card reading interpretations, but then this song came to me, and I know Prince is guiding us to play the song. So I'm going to play it. You guys, hey, Rebecca. You guys feel it. And then I jotted down some of the main lyrics and I will give you my interpretation. He will give you his. And then you guys can obviously give us yours. And one other thing I wanted to mention today was whenever someone posts something, and you know how we're a group of collective consciousness of light and love, we're all got that same intent and goal of expanding and awareness and love and light and our gifts and being one with source. Well, whenever someone posts something, and whenever, you know, when two or more are gathered in his presence, love and light, it expansiates, or whatever the word is, it expands. So I noticed that in the group, a lot of us will build off each other. We'll build and get, we'll take something and build upon it and get even more aware and get greater expansiveness. Sorry, he's trying to calm his dog down. He's whimpering for him, Wokey. So that's really beautiful. So when the other people were talking, it puts a light off, like ding, and then it gets bigger, ding, and then to watch another channeling, ding, and there's always this interwoven energy, especially within a collective consciousness moving towards the same goal and intent. So I just wanted to mention that. I can't remember exactly why now, but anyways, we'll play the Prince song. You guys feel into it, and then we'll interpret it. Oh, yeah. My point was that the with lightworkers in general, I think we all are pretty proud to label ourselves as crazy, you know, being different, and we take pride in that. But sometimes some people can get a little bothered by it or feel
overwhelmed,
or am I really crazy? When you have all these things happening to you, like you might have a second thought, am I crazy? Can I trust this? You damn effing right you can. It's that third language.
It's learning to trust your intuition before that which we are actually taught.
Yeah, we are not taught this stuff in school. And so sometimes the mind, it'll get in the way, try to figure it out when there is no logic to explain it. So this song to me is totally, totally appropriate. Every verse is appropriate. It totally explains what we're going through, why we've come, and why we have come here to pierce through the, you know, the collective consciousness.
The veils of the collective, if you will.
Which, you know, a lot of you guys already got your veils dissipating really, really quickly. So it's very awesome. You got the song up there, Caleb?
Yep.
All right, guys. So just tune in, listen.
And feel free to share your own interpretation as well as we go through this in the comments, and we can always elaborate and answer any questions. Or
yeah, but it's Keon. It's like Keon. That. Prince said, hey, play this for the group. So here we go.
All right, here we are.
Dearly beloved, we're gathered here today to get through this thing called life. Electric word life, it means forever, and that's a mighty long time. But I'm here to tell you, there's something else. The afterworld. A world of never-ending happiness. You can always see the sun, day or night. So when you call up that shrink in Beverly Hills, you know the one, Dr. Everything be all right. Instead of asking how much of your time is left, ask them how much of your mind, baby. Cause in this life, things are much harder than in the afterworld. In this life, you're on your own.
Feel free to get up and dance. Crazy. I know you guys have all heard it. So obviously let's go crazy. And crazy just means how we may appear to the norm. Crazy is like breaking the mold, releasing our true selves, expressing who we are. But a lot of times to the outside world, as you guys all know, it might seem crazy. So the first verse says, "Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to get through this thing called life." And even the first line, "Dearly beloved," you make reference to your dearly beloved, like your husband, your wife. To me, that in itself just opens it up, saying you are God, got partners with God, partners with love. And we are gathered here to get through. Well, when I heard that on the 80 station today on the way home, I kept thinking it said celebrate. But what it said is get through this thing called life. And no, Prince told me, and when I say told me, he wasn't literally sitting next to me, but I could feel it. And you know, when you put like thoughts in your mind, he said, no, you can use the word celebrate. Because he said, when he's in spirit, he sees things from a higher perspective. And he says that I can put the term celebrate, because get through makes it sound lesser than a celebration. It makes it sound more of a struggle. So he said that I could, use the word celebrate this thing called life. Do you have anything to add to that part, Caleb?
From my perspective, I believe, yes, when we go, when we say, let's get through this thing called life, it's more of a collective illusion, and it's to come and gather together in unity as one with love to pierce the veils and make it to the truth of our being. And that's oftentimes expressed through our own creative vibration, whether it is the channeling, the listening of music, the painting, the forms of art, because ultimately it's all guiding us home through this thing we call life, from my perspective.
Yes. Okay, so yeah, so I like the term celebrate. Prince agreed, he liked the term celebrate. And then it says electric word life means forever, and that's a mighty long time. But to me, the emphasis was electric because everything is electromagnetic, and life, how we see it, is the is an electromagnetic connection with our own energy. Our own energy is producing the life that that is mirroring back to us, that we are reflecting, and it is forever. It is never ever ending. And then it says, but here to tell you there's something else, the afterworld of never-ending happiness. So the afterworld is never-ending happiness. You can always see the sun day or night as part of the verse. So to me, you can always see the sun day or night, and it's never-ending happiness. The sun is simply the source, divinity, the light, and you see it all the time, no matter what. Like, it's always there. And that, to me, is just simply reflecting our connection that we can live now. We don't have to wait, per se, until the afterlife. We can be connected with that divine source, that love and light within us now, day or night. And not just the physical day when the sun's out and when the moon's out, but that's also symbolic and representative of good times or things that might seem more challenging, that we, through our connection to our eternal selves, spirit, we can always find the sun, the light, the positivity, the love in every situation.
What I have to say about that is everything we experience within the day or the night or just the now, since that's all we have, it is no separate from us, as the rays of sun are separate from the sun itself. We are ultimately the source of all creation within each and every now we experience.
So when you call, and then it says, so when you call up the shrink in Beverly Hills, the one doctor, everything will be all right. Instead asking him how much of your time is left, ask him how much of your mind is left. So it's really cute the way he says, doctor, everything will be all right, because everything always is all right. And time is an illusion, and it's the mind that we have to kind of release in order to get to the point of everything is all right. We can't stay up in here. We got to release and let, and then through releasing the mind, then everything always is all right.
We free up more of ourselves to flow into the now. When we step out of the linear continuity of our mind and into the now, we can have that higher intuition or higher source of intelligence flow through us into the now, and we can see things much more clearly. It's as if more veils are lifted the more we step out of our mind.
And then it says, because in this life things are much harder than the afterworld. In this life we're on our own. And it, at first I thought, what? That doesn't sound very good, we're on our own. But in truth and reality, we really are on our own, because we are the point of attraction to all in our life. And to get back to our source or our connection to our higher self, divinity, we do have to take the path alone. We have to be willing to put forth through our own free will the receiving of all that. We have to make the choice through our own free will. Yes, we want to take that path. We want to go back on the path of self-discovery and connecting to all that we ever are, ever were, mind, body, and spirit. So when it says you are on that path alone, you are. And you create everything in your path, around your path, the relationships. So it is a path you take alone. And how you take that path is the result you get.
And yeah. In alone, you find oneness, which you are one with everything. The path inward is ultimately by yourself, alone, into oneness.
And then it says, and if the elevator brings you down, go crazy. Punch for a higher floor, let's go crazy. So for me, it says, and if the elevator brings you down, to me, the elevator is the box that the mass consciousness put you in, the density. And it's the force of the mass, the weight that you might carry until you release yourself of it. So when it says, and if the elevator, which is the force of the mass consciousness, the lower vibrations, the density, the box they want to keep you in, brings you down, go crazy. Get out of your head. What is someone who has gone crazy? They might be referred to as gone out of their mind. Go crazy. Get out of your mind. And then I love this. This is my favorite line in the whole thing. Punch for a higher floor. Let's go crazy. So when you're punching for the higher floor in the elevator, you're simply lifting your frequency and your vibration into a beyond that which the elevator is trying to drag you down. You're connecting to that light. You are going crazy. You're getting out of your mind and you're connecting to that eternal, never-ending force of love and light, which is always right in here. It's in your heart, but it's like, get out of your mind. Let's go crazy.
And the paradoxical, you know, analogy of the elevator going down, well, aren't elevators typically also supposed to go up? And if everything's weighing you down, you do have to be that crazy individual to move up into higher levels, transcend the old collective, and nothing great was ever achieved by thinking realistically anyway.
Exactly. But that he made a really good point. The yin, the yang. For every force, there's an equal and opposing force. And so as low as you go, as heavy as life gets, as hard as it gets, guess what? Like Bashar always says, when you pull back the slingshot, as far back as you pull it back is as far forward as it can go. So you always have that opposing force. And then the other verse said, and if you don't like the world you're living, look around. At least you got friends. So to me, if you don't like the world you're living, look around. At least you got friends. Which is kind of contradiction of saying you're alone in the world. But the friends are the connection to spirit, to your higher self, to all the help available to you in the unseen world.
Within the reflection of yourself, because everything is a reflection of yourself. And if you're producing a reflection, are you actually alone with anything?
Right. That's an illusion too, because you are never alone, because if you are one with the one, then you are all one with everything. But for me here, friends also will manifest, obviously, in our physical world to help guide. But if you feel alone, not only are those friends, but to me, I feel the connection to the spirit friends. And then when it says, come on, lady, for a friendly word, she picked up the phone, dropped it on the floor. Ah, is all I heard. So to me, when it says, come on, lady, for a friendly word, pick up the phone. So she's picking up the phone. She's creating the intention. She is, through her own free will, making the choice to call the friend or the friend. And then when she picks up the phone and gets that kind word, she drops it and all they hear is ah, because then she is relieved. She has that sense of bliss and happiness and like ah. It's just like she chose to pick up the phone. She chose the communication between her and her heart, her and her higher self, her and spirit, God, whatever label you want to give it. Caleb, what's your take?
I believe, you know, who will answer the call when it comes from within, in a way.
Very good point.
Or it could be your mind calling you, and you're like, ha, nope, dropped it onto the ground, into the now, and forget your mind, and don't have a conversation with that which is calling you from your mind.
Very, very, very good. You have the choice, pick it up or not pick it up. All right, and then it says, look for the purple banana before they put you in the truck. And obviously, you guys are all gonna know, the purple banana, purple representing the top chakra, seventh chakra, Christ consciousness, that connection, that communication to your higher self, to spirit, to higher frequencies, to higher vibrations, before they put you in the truck. You know, with your straitjacket and wheel you off to where they want to wheel you off, put you where they think you need to go. They don't
like a nutty bunch of bananas.
There you go. I did not know how to really interpret banana, other than you made a point. The solar plexus being
it's typically yellow ray, which is also third density, the third chakra.
But look for the purple banana. Banana yellow is also yellow is also the color of sunny, cheeriness, warmth, happiness, sunny disposition. So the purple, what did you say earlier about the banana moving up through?
So bananas are typically yellow, and yellow is the third chakra, which is also representative in us living in the 3D, third density of the illusion, if you will. And rather than just be a nutty bunch of bananas within your third chakra, your solar plexus, move it up all the way to the crown chakra, which is why they then represent or say purple banana.
Yeah, that's so awesome. I didn't get that. That is such a good,
interpretation, if yes. you will.
And then it said, all excited, but don't know why. So put you in the truck and it says, all excited, don't know why. And to me, we do feel that excitement and we don't know why. That vibration, that sense of like, you can feel it in your body just vibrating and you don't know why, but what it is you going to that higher frequency, you connecting with that higher consciousness, you becoming a more truer version of you, and it feels good. And you don't have to have a reason, but they on the outside might question, oh, why are you so happy? What are you on? Or, you know, whatever. So all excited, but don't know why. You might not understand why, and they might not understand why, but it doesn't matter.
Because you're ascending and transcending old.
Ascending, very good.
Ascending and transcending older versions and reflections of your egoic self. And in order to do that, you do have to give up that ego and what the other people don't understand to trust that happiness and flow into higher vibration, ultimately.
Hi, Brianna. Someone else is here. All right. I didn't really expect too many people to be on tonight. So all excited, but don't know why, but just feel it. Trust it. There's no explanation and no words for spirit.
Or expression of source. So many people, they don't know how to explain or express themselves in words. First of all, words are secondary to our primary source of being. So any form of creativity is much more pure to a degree than anything words can transcribe, if you will. And also about not too many people being on. It's not about quantity. It's about quality and a level of delivery for the couple that are actually here. So thank you very much, everybody.
So what I was going to say is what you always say is, you are the thought behind the words, or you are before the thoughts. So that's another point.
Which is the vibratory intention, which ultimately creates and delivers our reality.
So you don't even need to know what's going on.
You just trust.
And feel it. And then it says, it says all excited, but we don't know why. Is it because we're all going to die? And what if we do, what is it all for? Better live now. So it says, all excited, but don't know why. Is it because we're all going to die? Damn right it is, because we're dying. Dying to the mold. Dying to the mind's logic. Dying to the stuff that the mass want us to put us on. Dying to the old self to become alive with the oneness, the love and light that we are. And
Eckhart Tolle says, the purpose of this life is to die before we die. What that means is to wake up to the truth of our being, which is the non-linear space-time complex continuity of our mind. So you break out of all that, and it's very challenging to die off to what the mind believes, because the mind is the only thing that creates past and future, and to wake up into the now. So we are all going to die, ultimately, into ourselves and back home, one with the infinite creator.
So yeah. And this also brings up the point, are we going to die to self, the little s, or are we actually going to die? Because if you never wake up to the little self, you're damn right you're going to die, because true nourishment comes from that love and light, and the physical body will die sooner because deep down it wants that connection. And if you choose not to have that in this life, you probably will, you know, you're going to want to die and expire in order to have that connection again.
Your higher self's bringing you home whether you like it or not, so enjoy the roller coaster of a ride.
Okay, and then it says, if we do, meaning die, what is it all for? Better live now. So,
keep going.
Before, okay, so I'll just read the whole phrase. So, if we do die, what is it all for? Better live now before the grim reaper come.
Which is just a physical representation of it coming to take your body away because it's no longer expressing and expanding, which is the reason why we are here.
And so when it says, if we're all going to die, what is it for? Better live now. So if you do die if you do die to the mind, you are going to live now. Better to die now before the grim reaper has to physically come and say, okay, you've had a hard enough life, time to take you back home. But wouldn't you rather live now before the grim reaper brings you home? You're going to live no matter what. You're going to live here or you're going to live there. Or you can live half asleep. So I choose to live now and encompass and express and use my free will to choose the light and choose the life now. And then it says the physical death just means you lost your life, your physical body. But I'd rather lose a false life and live now. I'd rather die now than die later. If that makes sense. All right, and then it says, because when you die to self, you connect to the eternal life. Okay, that's my interpretation. Because when you die to self, you connect to the eternal life and don't need to wait for the grim reaper. And then it says, let's go nuts, let's go crazy. So typically, let's go nuts, let's go crazy is in reference to losing your mind, which is exactly what light workers have come to do.
I believe that let's go nuts. Nuts are oftentimes seeds. Let's go crazy and plant new seeds of life and wake up to the now and our infinite heaven on earth and everything we actually desire.
And I really love that interpretation because he's right. When you're going crazy, let's go nuts, you're planting seeds. Every time you choose not to live here and you choose to live here, you are planting seeds, creating trees of light. Just, yes. And then it says, let's go crazy, let's go nuts. Are we going to let the elevator bring us down? No, again, the elevator, the mass force living in that box, dragging us down with the heavy, dense energies. Everything will be all right. And then it says, pills, thrills, daffodils will kill hang tough children. I didn't know what hang tough children was. That one really stumped me, so he looked it up. Hang tough means inflexibility. The term hang tough means inflexibility or firmly resolved. And to me, what it's saying is, everything will be all right. Pills, thrills, and daffodils kill hang tough children.
We are all children of God, and in order to really break free of our mind, oftentimes we do need pills, thrills,
daffodils,
which is still all beautiful to die to our mind. And I've used pills, I've used thrills, and I've experienced daffodils. And I'm a tough child of the infinite creator, and it does. It's exactly that. We'll kill and hang tough children.
Okay, when it says hang and kill, hang tough, hang kill means inflexibility. So you're killing the inflexibility. You're breaking that stubbornness, that stubbornness, that linear way of
continuity
thinking, inflexibility.
Yep.
So children, and when it says kill, hang tough children, meaning the children, you got to be like a child to kill, hang tough. Children are flexible. They're not stubborn in their mind. They're open to new possibilities.
They're malleable and pure love, light, presence of the
They're
now.
Malleable. They're flexible. They're open. So why it says, kill, hang tough children, he's coming, yeah, take me away. So kill, hang
That's
tough
your
children,
higher
he's
self
coming,
helping
yeah,
you
taking
along
me
the
away.
Way. Take you away.
Take me away. Take me away from the inflexibility. Take me away from the linear way. Take me away from that firm thing.
Those chains of the collective that no longer serve you.
So that was just, I felt really, really that I was supposed to share this with all you guys today, because I think that's, and I'm sure we didn't share anything that you didn't already know, but it's a reminder and it's a beautiful interpretation that Prince guided me to share with you today. And I just got a lot out of it. And I really, really understood too now that the why I feel like musicians, I'm not a musician per se, but I think like Christina was saying, that art is a form through vibration, symbols, like all artists. So as a light worker, we're called to be artists because we are, through our being, we are an artist.
Painting on the canvas of life through our own self-expression.
And I know that I'm not the only one that interprets music or movies and sees the symbols and everything, but it's kind of funny that the people that do that isn't necessarily the mass consciousness. It's the artists, it's the light workers, it's those thinking out of the box, it's those pushing the button to the higher frequencies, those making the phone call to higher self. So, and to sum it all up, that's what we are called. We are all artists expressing God's source, expressing our heart through our own individual stamp of energy that no one else could ever duplicate, ever. So it's so important. Well, not
to be
important,
to be an epic expression of source.
Yeah, and
through whatever creative means that resonate with you.
So, and that's just really beautiful. So again, I thank Rebecca, and I think this is like the most awesome platform so that we can share and culminate and keep expanding our collective consciousness, our artwork, our just, and it's just getting so big that the elevator is just going to shoot right out like on Willy Wonka in the Chocolate Factory. Again, another very symbolic movie. Very, very, a lot of symbol. Everything is, and all those people that made the movies, wrote the songs, the artists, they're all artists. They're all, they were all connected to that source, channeling that energy.
The Golden Ticket.
Oh my God, the Golden Ticket and Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. It's sweet. It's yummy. It tastes good.
It's playful. It's imaginative.
It's children love candy, and I always wish to outgrow that. And never ever. I still never ever land. Like a forever child, never ever land. Just like, that's just so beautiful because that's what, so beautiful because that's what we are. I think light workers, you never lose that connection to child. You're an eternal source of energy. There's no such thing as age. There's no such thing as numbers. There's no such thing as linear time. And we're really blessed to keep connecting in all those sparks, all those places where we keep like infusing our light or having those insights or sharing that which comes to the heart. And again, what I was talking about with the chocolate and sweetness, that's what it's like when you connect to your heart, because it's the most pure, sweet, most satisfying thing. You can never, until you connect to your own individual imprint, your own energy, you won't ever be satisfied, because that's why you came, and that's your true self, and that's your direct line of communication to God, to you, to your higher source that will guide you and show you why you have come, what your next step is, what your move is. And it always communicates through fun, love, laughter, peace, childlike. It's never heavy. It's not burdensome. It's not being stuck in an elevator going down to basement level. It's shooting up through the roof like Charlie and the Chocolate Factory right out there. And everything is all glass and they can see out. And there's no veil in that elevator either, was there? It was just an open glass vessel and they could see all the world below them. And that's what it's like to...
Wow, to gives me chills. We have to watch that movie.
To be one of us, because then also, not only are they out there flying, they got a large, higher perspective of the world below them.
And isn't there a bunch of bubbles that they're popping as if it was just popping parts of the collective they were transcending?
In the movie, yeah, they are popping. You remember the bubbling? And then they almost got stuck in that fan at the top. Oh my God, such an unbelievable, truthful movie. The fan, and it sucks them up, and then the grandpa had to pull Charlie down, right?
Hi, Stephanie.
Sorry. So beautiful. So important to stay connected. And just like they say, you got to be like a child to enter the kingdom of heaven. And the kingdom of heaven is just pure bliss.
The kingdom of heaven is actually within. And until you regain that childlike, pure presence of love, light, you struggle to go back within, because you're connected and tied up here. And you're just like, I just got to go home.
Yes, and you guys, and I know you guys all know this, but it's just like to reignite and relight everything within you. But he made a good point with popping the bubbles, because there are so many like little realities every day that we pop, and they're just illusions, and they're little like mini dimensions that you pop, and then you expand beyond, you pop and expand beyond. You get one thought, you get one revelation, one insight, one painting done, one card reading, and pop, it expanded into another one. Pop, and then you expand into another one, and you keep bursting all these miniature realities, because you're always creating a new reality a billion times a second and shifting to different levels of expansion.
A nanosecond. I don't know if you wanted to see if you wanted to do a single card. Maybe you ask her through the message or not, since she's there.
Ask who what?
If she wants a card reading.
Does anyone want a card? I don't know if I was going to do a card. I think I should pull a card just on the subject matter, like of what we discussed or what wisdom spirit wants to share with us as a collective group of, and I love the name of this group. Was it Cosmic Channeling? I love that. I love it. Because we are connected to the cosmos and we are multidimensional and we are connected to all these different realms and many different aspects of ours. And I just love it. And then we get all these beings that want to connect with us. All right, so I'll just do one quick card regarding everything that we talked about or whatever message that the collectives, higher selves, all coming together to present the card that's most appropriate for the collective. Sounds good, Steph? Good. All right, thank you. And I got this cute little bell, and someone gave this to me, and it's so cute because they didn't know I would use it to, like, you know, clear it, but it's so appropriate because all these cards are heart cards, and yet I get the little heart clearing. So all our higher selves of the collective group and all our hearts, let us know what is the most appropriate for this group to hear in the now before we pop another bubble and expand beyond that one. That one. And this one is a beautiful little shape. I love these abstract. So beautiful. This is on the beach. It's a little patch of seaweed. It's so almost like yin yang, because this one is like all filled in with the little seaweed. And then this one here, it's all connected and it's bright open space. And I'm trying to figure out if it's one plant or just one like strand, which I think it looks...
Or is it a combination of the collective coming together? Why does it need to be one?
Well, I'm just trying to just interpret that part first. But yes, it could be two separate plants or one, but regardless, it does form the heart. This one's all kind of bunched, but you can interpret it after, Caleb. I think you'll find that you'll have a good interpretation. I always like it when has these shoots off down into Mother Earth, because to me it's grounding. It looks like a clear-cut grounding rod. Bam. And this is on the ocean, and that's so appropriate. A lot of my cards are on the ocean, not just because I run on the ocean, but it's also representative of being connected to the heart energy, the ocean, the ebb and flow of emotions, that vast sea of feeling and ups and downs and all of that. And feelings are always felt through the heart. So to me, it really brings direction to the heart and the feeling. And so I will read the back and then we'll interpret the front. But I love this one. Ever since the course and all the readings, I haven't pulled that one yet. So the title of this is Ageless. Mm-hmm. It says, age is just a number, because in reality, you are an eternal being living in no time. Mm. As a human, you live and experience the age number as it pertains to mass consciousness. In choosing to transcend limiting beliefs, you shift to a no timeline where the unlimited you exists. So I would say that our collective has nailed it, because this kind of goes with our whole message exactly. And what it's saying is there is really no time. There's no linear time. Age is nothing. And as a human being, we create that. But when we do connect to our higher self, you break free of that. You connect to all aspects of who you are. When you connect to the heart is the meeting point of the spiritual and the physical. The heart connects you to all realms of existence of you, because that is where your God self lies. God is, you know, omnipresent. It's everywhere. It's timeless. There's no space and time. It exists everywhere at once, was, is, now, and ever shall be. Well, that's you. And when you tune into the heart, you tune into all those other realms, all those other yous. And you gain from all those yous that are gaining that experience. You're intertwined. You're connected. You're feeding each other. Nothing is separate from you. And it's from the heart space and connecting to that that you connect to that no time zone. Let me see if there's anything else here. And transcending, that's what we're all about. This group is all about transcending the limiting beliefs. And when you do, every time you transcend, every time you pop a bubble, you transcend and you go into that no time. You go into that no time zone where anything is possible. When I never really understood anything is possible, but when you really understand the physics of the heart or, you know, spirit, in the no time and no linear and everything exists now, anything really is possible through your
imagination. If you can imagine it, it is possible. Imagine. The mind is a tool that's been programmed in false ways, if you will.
So all of us are in an unlimited time, and it's really cool. What proves there is no time, to me, that I still find fascinating from a human, is like if you're doing a card reading in another zone, guess what? You're both in the now. Say California, I'm on the East Coast, 3 hours behind, right?
Just say a whole other side of the world.
Or the whole other side of the world, 6 hours difference. But then you come together to do a reading or whatever, and bang, you're both on the screen, you're both there, you're both here, and you're there now. You have transcended time. It's just amazing. That is like a literal fact where it can be proven. It just amazes me. Okay, so this card here, I think that is definitely representing the message on the back. This can be all the collective. This is all the density. If you look close, bunch of little mumble jumble, a bunch of little different people, or whatever, thoughts, consciousness, beliefs, paradigms, and see how it kind of clogs up that side of the heart a little bit. But it looks like when you can release it, and it's almost like dumping out a little bit here, when you don't feel and you can release all those paradigms or beliefs that no longer serve you, or things that the mass consciousness have taught you to be, even though they're really not, even though we chose it before we were born, when we let go of that, we create this wide open space. There's nothing in there. You create space for light, for time travel, for miracles, all of that. When you unclutter and let go of, to me, that's what it represents, all the entanglement. You can look at it that way. And when you do that too, and this is all green, which it represents also, it's a bright green too, and it represents the heart chakra and operating from the heart. And when it looks like, and when you do that and you open up, you ground, you open up the space, you allow for new possibilities, your own expression. And as you do that and tune into the heart energy, you're grounding your energy into the physical world to manifest whatever that is in your heart. That's one way to kind of look at it. But it also shows us all of the collective consciousness, all the density, it is all part of love also. All those beliefs, all those things that we may be shedding now, all those programs that we may be shedding now as a whole, has still served us in love. And that is very beautiful. It's not that we ever push anything away. We integrate it and we transcend it into something more beautiful. It has served me. It has taught me this. It has taught me not to be like this. It has taught me to tune into the heart. All those, say, lower, denser vibration, energies, challenges, things you've gone in your life, it has taught you to tune into your heart. So what a beautiful, beautiful thing. Anything you've ever gone through. So all of that, what we would consider negative, really nothing is negative. It's all beautiful, and it's all serving the greater purpose of love and to bring it forth. And that almost, I don't know what that is, almost like a music note.
It almost looks like a key to me.
A key. Very good, Caleb. Yeah, very good. That is the key. That is the key to unlocking the treasure, is taking all of your experiences, integrating them, being appreciative of them, loving them, saying thank you, but letting them go, and, you know, moving beyond all that. Anything else, Caleb? Hey, Mel, Lee. Yes.
So I also believe here it's made of seaweed here. And as we kind of swim through the sea of weeds, we have that key which unlocks the heart, which is the key, the secret to life, the key
Thank
to
you,
everything.
Stephanie.
And of course you have the balance, the yin yang there, which I believe is between the conscious and the subconscious battle there. And all of this being on the beach, representative of the ocean. We are no separate from our experience every nanosecond, as the waves are not separate from the ocean.
Very good. I love that part about the ocean and swimming the waves, because it's true. We swim through all the emotions and we feel it all in the heart. And very good. Very good interpretation.
Surf the waves. Don't go on. Don't worry about being drowned by them. Yes.
Yeah, very interesting. Yeah, and I didn't see the key, so that's a very good thing. So guys, thank you for... You, nice waves. Thank you, Stephanie. Oh, sorry. Thank you, guys. Hopefully you guys got a little something out of this. But I appreciate you tuning in and listening, and eternal love, light, blessings, and may you shine with the light of everything that you are in its entirety in this life, not other lives, but experiencing it all now. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Caleb. Thank you. See you again. Love you all.